There was Gondor. Oh shit, here they are. Hey, what up guys, it's Fish here and welcome back to some more Rise of Mordor action. I am finally back at my computer after an amazing trip. I went on holiday. For those of you guys who don't know, I went on holiday. I went to hang out with Apollo for like a week and it was awesome. We did lots of interesting and fun stuff. We also watched the entire Lord of the Rings trilogy as well as the last Hobbit film. Obviously all extended, obviously you can't do it when they're not extended, and yeah, it was so much fun. But I'm also really happy to be back and recording, because I had to obviously schedule all these videos for the week I was away, and I wasn't able to make any of these videos for you guys, which was a real shame because so many amazing mods came out in the time I was away. We had Rise of Mordor obviously release their YouTuber preview, which is what we're playing today. We had the new expansion for the Beyond the Wall Game of Thrones mod, the Seven Kingdoms mod, and we also have the Third Age Reforged mod for Medieval 2. All three of them games came out in the space I was away, which was such, it's so annoying because I wanted to obviously hit that hard, but I am back now, so expect plenty of Game of Thrones, Rise of Mordor, and more Third Age Reforged to come on the channel very, very soon, as well as obviously the campaigns I'm doing and all that lovely stuff. So yeah, today what I thought we'd do is just to kind of ease our way back into it, get me used to recording again, because it's been a little while. I thought we'd just have a fun little kind of encampment defense against a large enemy force. I believe we have around about, 3,000 men. They have around about 5,000 men. So the odds are definitely in their favor, but we do have the towers on our side. And it should just be a lot of fun seeing Gondor fight, because on my Rise of Mordor video, we actually saw like a whole ton of Dale units. We didn't really get to explore Gondor because that's what Apollo looked at. So it's going to be fun to play them. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started. I don't know where the enemy are going to be attacking from, but by the looks of it, that's a portion of their force. It doesn't look like their entire force, because I did give them around about 40 units. But we do have some soldiers over here. I also gave them all a decent amount of experience. I did give them a bunch of experience, as you guys can see, on their units. So, like, with their Uruk-hai, I just gave them 3 chevrons of experience. And then their more, like, elite units, these dragon skins, I gave them a silver chevron. And I did exactly the same with my units. So my, like, more elite units, these Gondor swordsmen, which we have ready to defend, they have 3 chevrons. And then, say, my Citadel Guard, which we have back here, are a little bit stronger, and they have a silver chevron. So let's run through the units I've brought, and we can look at the other units as well, because, yeah, I never get sick of just admiring these units. So for my main sword infantry, I bought these Gondor infantry. I think I bought about 5 of these guys. They're looking extremely potent. We'll form them up in shield wall as well. We'll definitely do that. So we'll form these guys in shield wall and watch them form it in slow-mo. It looks so sick as they just reform the line, clump up. The soldiers come forward to kind of, you know, sturdy up the infantry line. That looks amazing. So I bought 5 units of them guys. Then back here I have some Gondor archers. Again, I just can't get over how beautiful these armor sets look. They just look really, really nice. Gondor looks spectacular. The modders have done such an amazing job. Then we have some Ithilien Rangers, which are currently hiding in the encampment. They're hidden from the enemy. These guys also have guerrilla deployment, which is pretty cool to note. And we have some more Gondor infantry ready to give their lives to defend this encampment. Then over here we have some Gondor spearmen. This will be a better shot right here. We have some Gondor spearmen again, which I guess we can form up shield wall with them. See what they look like as the enemy is getting extremely close. We might have to actually click pause. Yeah, let's click pause whilst we watch this. Look at that. It just reminds me of Minas Tirith, you know, when they form shield wall and you have the orcs running through the gate, and, you know, Gandalf's obviously there telling the soldiers to hold the line and not to give an inch. It's awesome. Then over here we have some of our Gondor militia. These guys are just kind of like throwaway troops that bolster our numbers. However, they're not exactly very good, but, you know, they are men of Gondor, so we will use them as best to our ability. And as we move over here, we have some Gondor spear militia. Then finally, but by no means last, we have some warriors of Lasser. I'm going to give up trying to pronounce that. I'm just not going to be able to. But my heavy axemen, I believe these guys are in Third Age Total War as well. They're the axemen you can get in Third Age. They look really cool, though. I like how they kind of have the different flag and stuff like that. That's another thing I really enjoy about this mod, is the way that you don't just have, like, the iconic Gondor troops, and that's kind of it. You have, like, Gondor's a bloody large place, so it's really cool to see all these different, like, areas come together, and you have, like, men from all parts of Gondor, not just, you know, kind of the main iconic city itself. So it's cool to see that. Then, obviously, finally, we have the beautiful, the glorious, the Citadel Guard. These guys look so sick. I actually did, when me and Apollo were watching when we are watching I think it's The Return of the King, and it does a flashback to the scene of where Boromir takes back Osiliath from the orcs, when he's kind of talking about going to the council. You actually do get to see some Sith Guard in them. We pause it and was like, oh shit, these are the Sith Guard, and you actually do get to see their shields and stuff, so it's cool to see that kind of translate into the game. But that's my force. The enemy force is kind of just a mix of the evil units. We have some Harad units right here, pretty weak, but they are kind of just add up as the numbers. And we obviously have the Uruk-hai right here. I love their shields, they look really cool. It would also be cool to see, because again, when me and Apollo were watching Lord of the Rings, we actually noticed that the Uruk-hai who are pushing on the gate have these huge, like, full body shields at Helm's Deep. So it'd be really cool to actually see them be put into the mod itself. So cool, let's, enough of me talking, this has kind of been a pretty long intro. Let's get ready to watch this unfold. I obviously do have the OP towers as well. I'm expecting these guys to unleash a volley very, very soon. Here we go, the first volley of the archers. Unleash hell, boys. And these Harad soldiers are pretty lightly armored, so we should be picking away a few of them straight away. Come on, another volley coming in. Ah, it's beautiful. I really like, again, the changes they've made to the archer fire. I think the arrows just kind of really look awesome. Our ambush troops, I think our Aphelion Rangers are now up. Are we going to be continuing another volley? Oh, yeah, the Aphelion Rangers are now opening up over here. Oh, they did plenty of damage right there. That was beautiful. More arrow fire coming into my front line. I think this is going to be the first engagement right here. The Harad troops, I should be more than capable of taking care of the Harad troops as they clash in. Yeah, the Gondor swordsmen should be more than enough to take care of these guys. So they're lightly armored. My Gondor soldiers are pretty heavily armored and they're trained, so I'm not too scared over here. But it looks of it, there's no enemy incoming. Let's just go ahead and click this and click on slow-mo. But it looks of it, they're not sending any troops around this backside, so we can actually almost send some of our soldiers elsewhere. I should also probably form shield wall with these guys as well whilst we have the time to do so. So let's do that. We'll get our spearmen in shield wall and our swordsmen in shield wall as well. Oh, as these guys just like form up. That's so sick. Look at the spearmen. I actually feel like a little kid again, you know, at Christmas. Seeing this is just amazing. I can't wait until they add more factions in and add more units. Oh yeah, I also completely forgot to mention, I also brought a unit of these Gondor horsemen because they look great and I want to show them off for sure. So we can actually kind of, yeah, by the looks of it, they're not sending any men. So let's go ahead and reform the line. We'll get some archers over here. We'll send some spearmen. I think these guys are in shield wall. Yeah, they are. So let's go ahead and unshield wall these guys and send them back to the front lines to help our main lines. And then we'll go straight back in and look at more of the action, which is unfolding. Because obviously, I do not want to miss any action whatsoever. I think I'm also going to send these guys over here to help out. And I guess we can send some archers over here as well. Cool. Nice, nice, nice. So let's zoom in now. We'll stay on slow-mo just for a couple seconds because I want to see these guys just go to town on each other. Heads being sliced off. Yeah, I don't expect these Harad soldiers to really do well whatsoever. One of the Harad soldiers actually made it all the way back here. Shout out to him. And he is just going to town. Oh, he's dead now. He is so dead. Slice off his head. Oh, you're just slitting his neck. Oh, you slit his neck, but oh, and he kicks him down. Wow. I don't think I've really seen that animation in the full glory that just showed it in. That was awesome. Come on, hold the line, you brave, brave Gondor soldiers. You are men of Gondor. Okay, let's go ahead and click it on play now when when my screenshot button goes away, and then we'll kind of, you know, fully watch this. So we are doing plenty of damage over here. I'm expecting them to make pretty big headway over here with my Gondor swordsmen. I don't really think they're going to be able to do too much against the heavily armored Uruk-hai. That guy just got flipped! Oh my, I love the animations in this. That's awesome. It'd also be really interesting to see the full roster of these factions which are in here, because it's cool to note that the Uruk-hai have 200 Uruks in their unit, which is cool because it kind of, you know, shows the scale of them, and hopefully that will mean that kind of the Orcs will have 200 Orcs in their unit as well, as the Gondor spearmen just make their way over. That looks cool as hell. We also have the Axemen. I'm hoping they're going to be able to break me here. I might go a bit more aggressive just to let the Uruk-hai get in, because I did give them a fair amount of Harad, and I want this battle, like, I want the Citadel Guard to be defending to the last, as that Uruk just burns alive and he goes down. That actually looked really nice as well. I don't know if they've changed that. Oh, the dragon skin just gets his head sliced off with one clean hit. active a spear, the archer fire overhead. I believe these archers actually might have an ability as well to help boost them. Bring it down, bring it down. I can't wait as well. There's just so many things in this mod. Like, I can't wait till this, I can't wait till that, but I really can't. I'm super excited to where this mod's going. Obviously, it's going to be a really long time until we get to see any more additions to this mod. But I'm hoping that these videos, which all these YouTubers are doing, are motivating the team. Like, seeing you guys kind of react to their work, you know. Because modding is difficult. You don't normally get to see, oh, that guy's head's getting sliced. You don't normally get to see reward for your work in modding for a long, long time. You know, it could be 3 or 4 years till you really see, you know, release anything. So hopefully, you know, you guys commenting, us YouTubers loving this mod, will help motivate the team to keep on working and help them out a little bit there. Because that's the most we can do. We can give them constructive feedback, say what we like, say what we don't like, in obviously a constructive manner. Like, I don't really like this because of that, not just like, oh, this is shit or something like that. It never helps anyone. Oh, brutal. These Herat soldiers are getting cut to pieces, but so are my Gondor infantry. Let's have a look quickly. How's our front line doing? Oh yeah, these guys are getting wrecked. I think the Citadel Guard might have to go in and help out. We'll send in the rest of the militia, but the Citadel Guard are going to maybe have to move in. So let's move one unit of Citadel Guard over here to help out. Rest of our positions are holding pretty effectively. We might actually get some of these Aphelion Rangers as well to start picking away over here. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do exactly that. We also obviously have this cavalry we can send as well. I don't really want to commit it quite yet because I'm enjoying just watching these units fight. The swordsmen moved in yet? Oh no, the spearmen are being pushed right back. Yeah, the dragon skins are pushing the spearmen right back. Let's send in the infantry. Let's tell the archers to hold a fire over here. We're probably causing a lot of friendly fire. Swordsmen are going in now. Good, good, good. Come on, you brave soldiers. Let's do this. Let's end this this battle right here. Let's break the dragon skins. Can we break the dragon skins? That's a lot of their elite units gone. The Uruk-hai are fighting side by side with them. And a few people mentioned that they don't like the different sizes of the units, like, because this is from default Attila. But I really enjoy the fact that not every soldier is the same height. It kind of makes it feel a bit real, especially with Uruks as well. Because you'd have some Uruks which were a lot stronger than the others, you know. Lurks wouldn't be the same size as another Uruk, you know. He's a much larger one. So I like the difference, and I'm hoping they'll kind of specify that and go into more detail. Over here is our hardest kind of combat right now. As we get a few of them making their way through, but this is like a death alley. We're almost letting them come through just so that we can kill them here. That's nice. The fire towers themselves are also really helping. And your head's off. Oh, brutal. The archer fire is obviously also aiding us pretty effectively. Oh my god, look at the dead right here. So many Harad soldiers lying. I love as well, one of the things I know, this is a small details. Like, look at that on the back of their shoulder piece. And as the Gondor soldiers just stand there ready. As the Harad soldiers make their way, more and more of them dying. Nice, that looks cool. Then we'll make our way over here. How are our spearmen doing? Spearmen are not doing great, but the archer fire is definitely helping us. Who is breaking right now? It's no one on the front lines, right? No, it is not. The archer fire is coming in. The Aphelion Rangers are definitely picking them up. So let's pause it now because I want to send in the Citadel Guard as well. So let's set up like a nice defensive line here. I mean, even the general can come in around this left flank. We're starting to break them over here, which is good. These archers can hold fire as well. I think the archers have done their best for now, and all they can do is just hold. The balance of power is slowly shifting in our favor, but we are starting to run out on men. These spearmen are definitely breaking over here. But they have been reinforced by the sword infantry. So the sword infantry should really help out. I love the capes as well on that general unit right there. As we get right into the action. And it was awesome watching the entire trilogy with Apollo. Because, you know, we both love Lord of the Rings so much. Because normally when I watch it with my girlfriend, she likes it, but she doesn't like it, you know, as much as I do. So it was so cool to actually watch the Lord of the Rings trilogy with someone who loves the fantasy universe as much as me. Because we could just talk about it, you know, mention stuff that he didn't know, and he told me stuff I knew about it. It was really cool because, you know, we all watch the appendices and all the behind the scenes and stuff. But sometimes you just don't pick up on everything. So yeah, it was super cool to actually kind of just tell each other information and kind of also just say what we think about stuff. We talked about how, you know, it would have been cool, say, if like Sam died right at the end of the films, and that kind of uncorrupted Frodo. You know, maybe Gollum kills Sam as Sam sacrifices himself for Frodo, and that, you know, when Sam dies, that kind of made Frodo realize who he was and, you know, not to be corrupted anymore, and he destroyed the ring. Like, something like that would have been awesome. You know, that's just kind of the discussions we were having whilst we were playing, whilst we were watching, and it was just kind of really cool to do that. Okay, I think these Spear Militia need to be pulled back now. They are getting slaughtered out there. It's up to the Citadel Guard to get ready to hold the lines. Let's retreat them through. Let's form shield wall. Oh, these guys have Brace as well, which just... Oh, these are, like, super trained. Yeah, they're elite infantry. Let's pull these guys back. We'll pop our Brace ability on... Oh, this is, like, a toggle ability as well. So we'll stick on the Brace, and we will hope that the Citadel Guard can do their best and push back the enemy lines. Oh, they put down their spears as well. Beautiful. And I think we can always just shove in our general as well. Yeah, let's throw in our general. The rest of the Citadel Guard can come in and clean that up. These two, like, kind of bulges right here are being difficult to deal with. But we are kind of whittling them down whilst we break the rest of the infantry. So here we go. Let's watch the Citadel Guard. Actually, let's slow-mo this charge. Let's slow-mo this charge for sure. Here we go. The Citadel Guard charging in for glory for Gondor. Oh, as they just come clashing in into the side of the Uruks, we should be able to break this. And I think we just fully destroy this now. Come on, cavalry, let's end this. Let's support the general and let's break this line. The cavalry is going to be pouring in now. We can just about see them in the distance, just marching. And I also really look forward when they actually add some custom maps into us, because I think there's one custom map in this mod so far, which is actually like in our build, which is like some sort of cool river. So yeah, I'm really excited to see kind of the more maps they add, because the map tool is pretty bad right now, but I'm hoping they'll be able to add a bunch more going forward. I think that'd be really, really exciting. Citadel Guard doing a really good job of taking these guys out. They are elite trained, which is something I think I mentioned in the last video. But each unit kind of has a trained weak unit, like militia and elite. That's kind of their tier system, which is cool. It kind of is much better than the previous one. Nice, we kill the enemy general over here. Good on you, sword infantry. You guys were up against a lot of the weaker infantry, but they definitely did an amazing job. And the cavalry is coming in now. Let's go super fast. Then we just need to kind of come around and break this. The archer towers are just doing work. I wish I could have kind of disabled the archer towers. I think that would have been kind of cool. Because the archer towers are just so OP in Attila. So it would have been nice to be able to kind of like, I guess, kind of just turn them off. Like, I tried to see if I could do any I can't remember what it's called, where you kind of just destroy the city. I tried to do that, but it didn't really work, so unfortunately we couldn't have tried that. But we have our cavalry smashing in now, completely just annihilating these Uruks. They're not much longer left in the world. We even send some of the militia will rally to their general, and I guess we'll pop our war cry as well and manage to hopefully break these Uruks. But you know, the Uruks are sturdy troops. It took a pretty large amount of cavalry to actually break them at Helm's Deep, but they did break. So for those people who say that, you know, oh, the Uruks wouldn't break and stuff like that, they broke at Helm's Deep. Loads of them ran away. So that's a clear example to show, you know, that these Uruks aren't just mindless beasts. They do have some sense of running. But I guess maybe they could have been ordered to retreat by their commanders or something. The Gondor cavalry on top of their heavy steeds. I can't wait until they release the full Swan Knights, because a lot of people... Oh, that guy just got, like, whacked with the spear. Yeah, look at that animation. That's cool. Yeah, a lot of people were actually complaining about the Swan Knights for Gondor, saying they weren't, like, they didn't look like they did in Helm's in Third Age. And I think a lot of you guys got confused about that, because the Swan Knights, they aren't the proper full-on Swan Knights. They're just, like, one of the units from Dal Amroth. Whatever it's called. Is that right? Is it? I don't even know. I could have just butchered that and insulted a million people. But yeah, they do actually have, you know, that's not a full-on Swan Knight. That's kind of like a version of them. At least from what I gathered, that was just like a version of them. So let's bring these spearmen right on. Oh, no, let's get a screenshot right there of the victorious soldiers right there. Let's even bring up these archers as well. Right, so, oh my god, we actually might maybe break here. That's not good if we break there. I think they're okay, but the fire arrows are definitely hurting them a little bit. Let's form up like a nice little line here of archers. Oh, look at that. Look at the amount of dead just laying there. That is full on brutal. The amount of dead bodies. Brave soldiers. Brave soldiers indeed right there. We'll get one going down the battle line as well. Even if, maybe if we kill this guy. Oh, that was sick. Let's zoom in right here. Watch their shield wall. Men of Gondor, you are brave soldiers. Let's go back to the main battle line now. This is kind of the last bulges. They have definitely made their way, but the piles of bodies have just kind of occurred on top of each other. It'd be cool to see maybe in a future Total War, actually having, you know, the bodies literally pile up on top of each other. So soldiers have to kind of step over them and fight on top of them. I imagine that would be super hard to actually kind of design the AI to go on top of the terrain. But it would look cool nonetheless. We have our archer volleys going overhead as well. We have more Gondor swordsmen if we do need to send in. I think this right flank is struggling a little bit. So let's send over some Citadel Guard to aid them in their struggle. We can also send some soldiers round the back. We obviously also have this cavalry to end up the enemy. So let's send out that cavalry. We'll move up our general as well. And let's throw in the axemen as well. The axemen haven't actually been involved in this engagement yet. So let's get the axemen involved before we kind of hammer and anvil any infantry. We'll just watch these Gondor soldiers march. Oh, the Citadel Guard. Look at them. With their capes as well, just fluttering in the wind. That's a cool sound as well, as the armor like jiggles. So yeah, axemen, go in, help out our brave warriors holding the line. So in you go, boys, to the front lines. Give our men a rest. Oh yeah, they are pouring through. Look at that. Oh my god, they are slamming into the enemy. That charge was devastating. And they are just breaking. Oh my god, they are breaking these Uruks. The armor is weak, as Legolas says, it's between the neck. So this is exactly where the axemen are heading to. So let's get these guys round. Let's get a nice little charge like right there. And then we'll charge in into the backs of these soldiers. But I want to watch these axemen. I definitely want to watch these axemen because they are doing work against these Uruks. I guess the Uruks are quite heavily armored. And axemen are pretty good against armored units. The archer fire is obviously also helping out pretty nicely as well. Cavalry is getting ready to form up and break their units over here. Yeah, the axemen, look at the gaps they're bringing up here. Oh, these axemen are strong. Cavalry charge, here we go. The brave Gondor knights smash. Oh my lord, they just ran them down onto the swords. I think that's going to completely break them. Let's tell them to charge in. Yeah, there we go. We completely broke them. Let's get the cavalry round the side now, round here to help out. The Citadel Guard over here ready to help out? I think they are. Or did I already order the Citadel Guard in? No, the Citadel Guard, charge in, help out your brothers. I think this is going to be a victory for sure against the Uruks. The Citadel Guard making their way forward. We'll slow-mo the camera down a little bit as well so we can fully... Oh, look at the distance right there. You see the Gondor horsemen making their way around. Let me know in the comments down below what your favorite unit is in the mod. I'd be really interested to find out what you guys like, just what unit you guys like the most. For me, I think it's probably just like the basic Gondor spear infantry. I just think they're so iconic from the film, and it's really awesome to see them in this game. Like, I think that's just my favorite unit. Even though it's kind of boring, you know, you have the Citadel Guard, you have the Fountain Guard. Oh, this cavalry charge is just so dangerous. The wounded infantry as well, rallying forward their axe brothers as they charge in. The cavalry is trying hard. It would be cool as well, maybe, to have these guys pull out swords when they go into combat. That would be something nice to see. But yeah, we're going to rout these guys. I think victory is almost at hand. Yeah, look at that. One more cavalry charge round here. If we even need it. Oh, look at that. The Uruks are running. They're fleeing for their lives. Luckily, there's no Ents in the distance, but they could be Ents. Who knows? Ready to kill them. And I think our Citadel Guard are going to finish off this engagement. Oh, that looks sick when they have their shields up as well. I think the Citadel Guard are going to run forward and chase down the rest of the enemy infantry as they flee. And there we go. Victory is ours as the cavalry comes pouring in. Beautiful. I fucking love this mod so much. I mean, even just all these aesthetics like this just makes it feel like the faction you're playing. So let's end the battle and see who racked up the most kills. So the Uruk's doing pretty good. Obviously, the fire arrows really made it difficult for them to do damage. And obviously, all these stats and everything like that are still to be worked on. I can't imagine, you know, the Uruk's doing this poorly against just normal Gondor infantry. I imagine they're going to kind of buff these guys a lot as they get more developed. But for now, you know, this is kind of all they've got done for them. So obviously, expect the stats to change and everything like that to make it a lot more competitive. I really hope they make kind of almost make the evil factions OP. I think that'd be kind of cool to see, because obviously they have trolls and Mumikil and stuff like that to also add to their roster. So my infantry doing good, and remember as well, I was in shield wall when they had no missile support to pick away at my shield wall. So it's kind of another way, you know, it's kind of hard to fight this when they don't have any cavalry or archers or missiles. Because normally, you know, the Uruks would just, you know, just shoot my shield wall to pieces before they even came close. Their crossbows would be deadly at destroying these guys. So yeah, my Gondor infantry doing really good. The Citadel Guard doing pretty well as well. The archers doing nicely, even though I didn't really use them too well. And obviously the Gondor cavalry doing plenty of damage. One last thing, I just want to quickly show off this again. I love this. It's, again, such a small change, but it makes you feel like you're playing a different game than just Attila Total War. It makes you feel immersed in the universe. So I'm going to end the video here. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, make sure to drop a like and a comment down below. Let me know what scenarios you want to see next in this mod. I have a few ideas. Me and Apollo are thinking about doing like an Aphelion ambush, where we have the Aphelion Rangers in like an ambush battle and we just shoot, you know, some Uruk-hai to death. Like, what if maybe Faramir sent some Rangers to go help out at Helm's Deep and they kind of didn't make it in time, but they made it just in time to kind of ambush some reinforcing troops. And someone also suggested in the comments as well that we do kind of like a caravan escort mission, which I think is also going to sound pretty cool. So hopefully you guys are looking forward to more of this. If you are, as I said, drop a like and a comment, and I'll see you guys next time, and fish out.